خیلی ها در ایالات متحده آمریکا
Many people in America and even more so outside the US don't even know that there is a third party candidate on the ballot. Why is that, you think?
I would suggest that the media is not doing its job. And by the way, the media doesn't have to agree with us. They don't have to like us. But I would suggest that having a third person on the ballot in all 50 states is definitely newsworthy and something they should be informing their viewers about. I mean, that's the job of the media, is to let them know what's going on. And so many times we meet people and they say, what? You mean I've got another choice? They're shocked to hear about that.
اگه بخواید یه تصویر کلی به ما بدید در مقایسه با
Can you give us a picture of what are the main differences between the Libertarian, Democratic and the Republican party?
Well, first of all, I would put the Democrats and Republicans in one category and say that they think that they know better than us how to spend our money, how to make decisions and so forth. Libertarians think people should make their own decision and that we should be able to make different decisions. So let me give you an example with education. The way it works with the Democrats and Republicans is, let's say you want prayer in your school and your neighbor doesn't. What you have to do is you have to battle it out. You each have to support your own candidate, donate money, get all your friends to vote, put yard signs out, and then on election day, one of you is going to win and one of you is going to lose, and you're all going to have to live under the same system. Under the libertarian way, you keep your resources, and if you want to send your kid to a school with prayer, you can do that. If your neighbor wants to send his kid to a school without prayer, he can do that as well. So you can get along instead of battling every decision.
You know, one of the arguments against the Libertarian Party is that you leave pretty much everything to the individual. Shouldn't there be a role for the government when it comes to issues like education or healthcare, which are extremely important these days?
I would suggest that government has made insurance and healthcare unaffordable. In fact, the United States is the only country in the industrialized world that has health insurance tied to its employment. So we've got people, when they lose their job, they lose their health insurance, or they hate their job, they can't leave their job because they hate their job, but they need their health insurance. That's because of the government, because in World War II, the government instituted wage and price freeze controls. And so companies weren't allowed to offer bonuses or signing bonuses or increase people's salaries. So they said, okay, we want the best employees. How can we get better employees if we can't pay them more? And they said, I know, we'll give them benefits. And so they started handing out benefits. So government tries to fix one problem, they create 10 more. Wouldn't it be nice if we could have our health insurance separate, just like our car insurance is? Also, if you look at true insurance, you see that costs tend to be held down. What we have in our country isn't real insurance. And that's probably the answer to another question.
خب ببینید، اینجا در اروپا که خیلی از کشورها در واقع بیمه عمومی دولتی وجود داره.
Well, look here in Europe where many countries have a state-provided healthcare. Some people think it's absolutely crazy that in America, if you can't afford to buy health insurance and you get sick, you may end up dead on the street.
خطر وجود داره که حتی وسط خیابون بیفته و بمیره.
Well, because, let me mention, if there's one message I could get to every American voter, it's that we don't have a free market system. So some people look to the United States and they say, well, the free market doesn't work, but we don't have a free market. And as far as all the people in Europe looking at America thinking we're crazy, we are crazy. Our health insurance is crazy and it shouldn't be tied to employment. And that's the fault of the government. So I would look to a place like Singapore, which has more of a free market in which doctors and healthcare providers compete, and you can get different levels of care based on what you want. And I think the best example is to look at car insurance. What if car insurance paid for all costs? What if car insurance paid for gas, oil, and car washes? First of all, you would have absolutely no reason to shop around for the best gas prices. In fact, you might go to the fanciest gas station and get free coffee while you wait, because what do you care? You got your little $5 copay card and off you go. That means the gas stations wouldn't have any reason to compete. they'd simply pass the higher prices on to the car insurance companies. Then the car insurance companies would increase our car insurance premiums. And we'd get in that spiral that we have right now in healthcare, where there's nobody holding the cost down on healthcare. And if you look at the only two somewhat free market systems in the United States, which would be cosmetic surgery and LASIK surgery, because insurance doesn't pay for those, you see the costs held down. In fact, over a 20-year period recently, LASIK eye surgery costs went down 70% over 20 years, while during that same period, healthcare costs went up 125%, because when people shop around with their money and they get to keep the savings, they look for the best prices and people look to compete to make things better.
Let's talk about foreign policy. I know that your party is not a big fan of U.S. intervention, but some would argue that America is a force for good, that if it wasn't for America, the world would have been very different after the World War II.
First of all, World War II, some people think we should have gotten into it, others don't. A lot of historians say that the reason Japan bombed us was because of our tariffs and our trade policy. So if our trade policy had been good and we had open trade, then maybe they wouldn't have bombed us to begin with. In fact, I point out that Japan would never bomb us now because we buy so many Toyotas and Hondas, and you tend to not bomb your best customer. So what I want to do is I want to have free trade around the world so that people don't attack us. But I would say, you know, it doesn't matter what we do. If we intervene somewhere, that's going to make somebody else not happy. And if you look at, right now President Trump is touting his peace accord, but not everybody's happy with it. So no matter what you do, you're going to make enemies somewhere. And I've been telling Americans that I want to turn America into one giant Switzerland, armed and neutral, to defend our borders and to be good world neighbors with the rest of the world and to strive for peace.
As you know, Iran is under U.S. sanctions. Would a libertarian president, would President Joe Jurgensen put sanctions on a country like Iran? And do you think that sanctions are effective in changing the regime's behavior?
Absolutely not. I think that makes us a bully. And I think that just gets countries mad at us. But you're absolutely right. There are countries where there's going to be dictators. There are countries who are going to have tariffs. There are countries who aren't going to be fair. But that doesn't mean that we can't be a citizen. There's no reason why we shouldn't allow our citizens to trade with anybody who will trade with them. And no, sanctions is just asking for trouble.
One of the first immigration policies of Donald Trump was to issue an executive order to ban the citizens of several countries, including Iran, from traveling to the United States. What do you think about the travel ban?
No, I want open borders like we had before the 1920s. When my grandparents came over, that immigration is what made our country great. If you look at GDP, GDP goes up when we have immigrants come over. And a lot of people complain about crime, but actually people born on foreign soil actually commit fewer crimes than Americans born on American soil. And yes, I think it's egregious that we're not allowing refugees into our country who possibly helped Americans. I mean, those are the people we should be welcoming, people who have American values and who are helping our country.